हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द न्यू वीडियो ऑफ माय चैनल। सो आई एम स्टार्टिंग ए न्यू सीरीज ऑफ फोर डिफरेंट वीडियोस वेयर वी विल लर्न हाउ टू ऑटोमेट एक्सेल। एंड टू ऑटोमेट एक्सेल वी विल बी यूजिंग द पाइथन लाइब्रेरी विच इज कॉल्ड पांडास। सो पांडास इज वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग लाइब्रेरी, पीपल यूज इट फॉर डेटा एनालिसिस, फॉर मशीन लर्निंग, फॉर आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस, एंड डेटा साइंटिस्ट आर यूजिंग पांडास अ लॉट फॉर यू नो वर्किंग ऑन डेटा। I have divided this into the four different steps which you can see on my screen, okay, and understand what all you will get in these different four videos of my channel. Okay. All right. So people who are new to my channel, okay, they can subscribe my channel to learn more and more on Python and automation, and you can forward my videos to your colleague to whom it will be useful, and you can like my videos, and which will help me a lot. Okay, so first thing that we have to create a project, and we have to install pandas into our Python scripts. So let's go there and install pandas. So I am going into the folder where I have installed my Python. You can see my other videos about how to install Python and how to add libraries. This that all I have covered in other videos. So I am here in Python folder. You can see Python file is available, and in same path I have this scripts also. Okay, now what I have to do is I have to first select this entire path and write cmd and enter. So I will be automatically redirected to this cmd path, and then what I have to do is I have to install pandas now. Pip install pandas. So how to install other libraries, you can see my video, or you can go and look into my channel and see the video how to install libraries, and then I will put enter. I already have this, so it will show that our requirement is already satisfied, but for you it might take, you know, 5 to 10 seconds or 15 seconds, and it will show the message that pandas is installed successfully. One more thing which you have to check is a new numpy. Numpy is the library. Okay, so this also I have, but for you again it will take around 8 to 10 seconds to get installed. All right, so now we have libraries. What is the next step? I have to go and create a project. So to create the project, I have to start my IDE, which is the editor. So I am getting this over here, start new project. I can, and when you are starting new project, you can check from here. I am using, you can use the virtual environment also, but I am using the system interpreter, this one. You can see this circle. And I will write a name of the project which I want to give, Automate Excel. Okay. I have done videos on browser automation also. You can find the link in the description. Then create. So if let's say you are not getting that option and you are directly getting this file, then you can create new project from here also. File, in the file you can see new project. Okay, so now we have the project created, and you have to click on this folder icon, right click, add new file. Now when you are adding the new file, what you have to do is you can give a name like right click, new file, bay of so first point is now next thing which we required is we required some data, because We need data to perform the action. So what I will do is I will give you one site name. Okay, you can see the URL. This complete URL I will put into my description also. Or if you want to browse, you can browse easily. And you can download this file sample. The file size is 163.50 KB. Okay. And you can download this file from here. Let's go to the folder, download folder. So what I want to do is I want to save this file with different names so that I can explain you that how to work on different file types. Okay, so let's save this file. Save as. Enable saving. All right, and I will directly go to my project folder, Python projects, and I should have my project over here, Automate Excel. I will name this file as Excel data.xlsx. Or what I can do is I can select the format from here, which is XLSX, you see on the top. Okay, and then save this as Excel. Now I will save this as CSV. So file, save as, and then CSV data, and then I will save this file as comma delimited, and then it is saved. Yes, okay, and then I'll keep this open because I have to see what is there in the data. So let me move to the project folder now. So when you are creating the project, you should remember the path so that you can easily go in the project folder. And then here I am. So, and here is my script. Now, first step that we have to import our library, which is pandas. And then I will give a short name to it as PD. Okay. And the second point that I want to show you that how to read the data. So data frame is equals to pandas PD dot. So this is the function. There are different kind of functions in pandas. You see read CSV, read Excel, and you read array. And there are so many read HTML is also there. Okay, so if you will go down, you can see there are so many options. Dot you read, yeah, so HTML, JSON, Oracle, okay, and HTML also will be there. So you can see SQL, SQL table, you can read anything. But as of now, we are using read CSV. In case if this drop downs or these suggestions are not showing in your editor, you can directly type it. Okay, so if I am using the file outside, so as of now I am using in inside my folder, so I just R, it has to come R inside the columns. You can use this entire path you have to provide. So the CSV is CSV data dot CSV. CSV data dot. So this is how the path should look like. Now I want to check that data has come into the data frame or not. So what I can do is I can just print, use print. I can print the four or five lines. So how do you print four or five lines? data frame dot dot you can use head, and then you can use five line I want to print. Just want to check that if it is data reading is successful or not. So you see the five lines here. Okay, now I want to use this for Excel, let's say. So read Excel, I just have to change, and then I have to change this file name to Excel data dot XLSX. So we have the data from Excel also. So both the files we are able to read. Which are the files? Let me show you. These are the files. This is CSV and this is Excel. As we can see that this file pandas.py and these Excel files are in the same folder. So I mean the project folder. So what you can do is you don't need this long path. You can use this single name also. Okay, so what I will try to do now is, as the first example, you understand that sometime you have to keep only few columns out of your entire work. So to have few columns, what you can do is you can create a list of the required columns. So required columns is equals to, so when you use this curly braces, okay, Python compiler will understand that yes, this is for list creation. Okay, so let's see what is the data we have. So let's say we want to select this column and then product and then unit sold. What we can do is copy this column name from here and then this comma, another column which we want to keep is product. Okay, another column which we want to keep is unit sold. Units sold. So let's say we want to get only these three columns. So now we have created the list. So what we can do is we can create a new data frame. Okay, so the create new data frame, what all you have to provide as a syntax, you have to provide data frame name and SORCE source data frame and then column 1, column 2, and then dash dash dash. Same thing you have to keep doing. So this is the basically syntax. Okay, now let's come back to the code which we already have. So I will create a new data frame now, which is required, REQUIRED, required data frame. Okay, so when I say required data frame, so I need the data frame with these columns. And which is my source data frame? Here is the source data frame. Source data frame is data frame and then required columns. Okay, now let's write the file here. So required data frame dot to Excel is the method, and then I have to pass the name, okay, required Excel dot XLSX. So this is what I want to write. And now let me show you the another example. So you want to required CSV. Don't go to my spellings, I just want to explain the method. Okay, You can keep any name whatever you want and then CSV. I'll tell you index false. What is the meaning of this? I'll just show you. So there is a column which will be added when you are writing, which will show you the row index, row count or serial number, you can say. Oh yeah, so the mistake is over here. I have to change this into CSV. Let's go and check the file folder. Automate Excel, you have two different files just now created. Okay, you have these three. So you see only three columns are here. Now let's open Excel. You see there is one additional column. Those three columns which we required are here. But additional column which is showing us the row count. So if you don't want it, it is not there in CSV file. Why it is not there? Now let me explain you the reason. I will close these files because if I will keep these files open, I cannot run the code after a few lines. So in CSV, I had mentioned index false. If you will mention index false, you will not get the serial number of the row in the additional column. So if you want to avoid that, you can use this. Okay. So now let's move to the next topic. Sometimes we have to filter out the data. I mean, we have to delete some rows out of the data, and we have to create a new file out of that data. So if you want to create new file, you can create new file. If you want to create same file, so you can create same file also. So I will explain you now how to delete the data, and I will be showing you two different methods of deleting the data. First method we will use that is filtering the required data and then leaving the unrequired data. Okay. So for that I will just write. I will create a filtered DF, in the sense data frame, equals to what is my main data? Data frame. Data frame, and out of data frame, what I need is I need only that data frame where country is equals to, or I think country there is a column, and we will take value France. So you see that I don't need this data basically. So what I will do is not. I will just make use of not. And in case if you want only the data which has friends, then you can just remove this not. You can mention equal. Okay, you will see more examples. This is just starting. I am creating a long series, so you can watch all four videos and you will be better. So don't try to learn everything in the beginning itself. So this is the filter data frame where the data frame is excluded. Okay, so now let me try. Filter df is equals to, I will write it to Excel, let's say exe. So I will write delete France dot XLSX. So you always remember, okay, whatever you are using here, it should match with this. So now let's write this, run this code. Oh, sorry, this is country, COUNTRY. Let me check the spelling once again, COUNTRY, correct. Okay. Now let's see this file, delete fans. What is the data inside? Delete fans. Open the file, please. You see in country if I go, okay, you will not see, I'll put the filter for your quick reference. You will not see France here. Okay, but if I see my main data, I will close this file now. Then I have France here. Okay, got it. So this is how you can filter out the data which you don't need. And now next method is, so this is the filter out the unrequired, unuseful, I will say, use data. And the other method is drop the rows. How to do that now, the question. So what I will do is that here I have just filtered out the data and I have created a new data frame. So this time what we will do is that we will be using the same data frame. Okay. So data frame dot op drop. So we want to draw from same data frame. What we want to drop from, where we want to drop is that we have to tell this, now we have to put condition over here. So let's see the Excel file and then put the, so what I want to do is gross sale. So if I will go in the gross sale, I put the filter, I can see here there are so many rows which are less than 5000. Okay, so let's try to delete everything which where it is less than 5000. So that is how we will take the example. Alright, so if less than 5000, you drop from the data frame. And one thing is something missing, I think. 3, 2. Yeah, I have to give the internal data frame. Here column name will come as what? Gross sales. Data is gross sales here, and then I can give the condition 5000. So you see the data frame, we have to drop something, and then from where, how will, what we want to filter out, you have, we want to filter out the data frame column. So you have, you are, this is the filter area, this is, you are creating a filter only, this one. So you see this is the filter, so square brackets is coming two times, that you have to remember. So this is the filter area which I have selected. Okay, and this is the data frame which will be returned. And then can equals, yeah, so index. Why we are writing this index? Because once we have removed the rows, the serial number will be changed. Okay, and then in place equals to true. So in place equals to true in the sense that I am using same data data frame. I don't want to change the data frame. I just wanted to, yeah. So you see here I am I am filtering the data, I am creating a new data frame, but here I will not be creating any new data frame. I will be using same data frame. Okay, and now let's try to write the result. Data frame dot to Excel drop gross sales dot XLSX. EXEL. Okay. Now I will run this. Dropped gross sales. Let's see if we have anything more than 5,000. So you see sales, we don't have anything more than 5,000, because the filter method which we have put is less than 5,000. So less than 5,000 whatever was there, you see, I'll explain you once again. Okay, so the condition is less than 5,000 whatever is there, it should be dropped out of the data frame, which is our source data frame, and then we are writing the data frame once again into the file. Okay, so this is how you can exclude. Now let's come to replace. And for replacing, okay, I will be, you can hold the video here and you can practice this part which is there. And then I will move to the replace one. So let's say I will read the data frame once again. So the new DF is data frame I am using. Now I am root you, I will use this time CSV file. So pd pandas, because you see the name we have taken of pandas is pd dot read CSV, and then we can give the CSV name CSV data dot CSV. This is how you can read it. Okay, and you know how to check the data frame, like new df. New df dot head 5. So we'll just check if the data is getting read successfully or not. Yeah, so I have to see, I will tell you the reason, because I am writing this, whenever I will run the code, this file will be written again and again. So I have kept this file open, so this is why this error is coming. So whenever you see the permission denied, you can check that if any file is opened or not. So when you are reading, it will not give any error, but when you are writing, it will give error. Okay, so now let's run this code again. We want to check this piece of code. Yes, we are able to read the data here. You can see the data to CSV. Now what we want to do is that we want to replace, what we replace, we want to replace sales. So out of sales we want to replace this dollar sign. Oh no, that will not be a good one, because if you see the format, it is already going out. Okay, So what we want to do is we want to replace this none with this. One second, let me open the CSV file better. So method will remain same for all CSV and for other also. Yes, in CSV because yes, in CSV you can see because CSV will not change the format itself. So you see there is a, this is very important point. You see the space is coming over here. Okay. And then first we will remove this space, then we will remove the dollar sign, and then we will try to convert the format into integer or a float. It will go to float because you see the decimal over here. Let's start the work. We'll remove this file because this is not required one. And so new df, which is my fresh data, because I am reading the data once again. So I will read fresh data. This all is gone. Equals to pd dot read CSV. Sorry. So what I want to do is I want to change the sales. You see the column name. So I want to change the values inside this column itself. I don't want to create a new column. That I will tell you in the later stage of this video how to create new column with new values. So I want to replace dollar and the comma. So let me go here equals to, I want this column to be written by this itself. So same column, same. Dot replace. If you don't get this kind of suggestions, okay, you can write, it's not a problem, you can write yourself. So I want to replace, let's say dollar sign first, okay, in the first line. So I, whenever you will replace any special character, you have to use this for backward slash, and then you give the character, and then you give the comma, and then you, we have to replace it with nothing. So nothing in the sense, you see there is nothing. I have just used these apostrophe commas. There is nothing in between. And then to remove junk values, regular expression is the regex. So you see the regex is here. Equals to true. Okay. So this is how you do. And the second, we want to remove the, so let's say what kind of data we can see over here. You, if you want to print only one column, how can you do it? Print. So I want to see the column. What is the status after this line? What I can do is I don't want to write the data into file. I just want to check it here. So sales key errors. Now I am sure this is the CSV format. So you will have these kind of issues. See, space is available here. So how to remove the space from header, that I will explain you, okay, in my other video that you can learn. But as of now, we have to deal it, we have to do it manually. Okay, and then now let's try what's coming. So you see, I can read the data. So and dollar sign is not there. Now, if you want to see the data before and after both the times, what you can do is before this line. Sorry, I missed this. Had three rows I want to print. Dot had three rows I want to. Print before, three after. So this is how you can check. So you see, if I will just extend this window, before it is X and then after, no dollar sign. Okay, so I don't need this line, just wanted to explain you. Now next. So we have done this. Now we have to remove comma. If you want, you can write dot replace over here, and then you can remove in this line, but I will not be using that. And you can remove multiple values in a single line of code, okay, which you will learn later. I wanted to keep everything on the basic side in this video. Okay, so now what I want to do is I want to remove comma. So I will copy this entire line. Enter. And here I have to remove this and comma. So you have to focus over here. So you can see one more comma with little reddish color. This comma is for syntax. Okay. So syntax for replace is, I'll just write the syntax. Replace bracket your old value bracket comma, and then inside your new value. So this is how the syntax is. So you understood. So my old is comma and my new is nothing. Okay, again I will just print the head of this one. Okay. Dot head and three rows I will print. I'll see what is there. Okay, let's see this once again. So you can see there is no comma now. Now let's say in any case, if you have to replace this data type also, you have to change the data type to float. How will you do it? You can do simply like dot as type, and then you can write integer. It will take float because it's in decimal. Okay, and then you see, so it will not show you any difference now. Data type is coming float. We don't need this file also. So after overriding the sales column, we have this new data frame ready, and then to let's write it to CSV itself. Sales column and then updated. Sales column updated dot CSV. And here I will just, I don't want that index column. Okay, so index false. All right, let me run this and then let me show you the sales column updated CSV. This is my original CSV. So you see the sales in original CSV now here. You see the sales column updated in. So you see in all other columns you can see the comma and all, but here you cannot see anything. Okay, so this is what we have done. Now let's minimize this from here. This is the output run code window, and then scroll up, you will see the code once again. Okay, so I just want to show you the entire code so that I can move on the next topic, and you can pause your video till here and you can see the code on single screen. and you can practice this before I move on to the next topic of this same video. So the next topic is that we want to add age column. So many scenarios, even I have been working in offices, so I have seen that all the people who work on Excel, okay, they have to write the age of some record from the date column. So they will get some date and then they will write the age. For that, let's move ahead. So what I will do is I will be writing the age in this column, new data frame itself, or rather I will just read the data frame once again here. You don't have to read it again and again. So let's say I want to write the date in the same data frame, the new data frame. Okay. So whenever add new value column with age. Okay. So how can you add new DF and then simply you can write age equals to the first thing which I will suggest before we are going to age is let us see the data, how it is looking, which column we have to target. Yeah, so we have a column called date. So this is in the correct format only, in date format, but sometime how do you know in the date format? You go right click, check the format. You can see the date format is here, but sometime you will get this column in the, so don't forget to remove the space if it is inside. So yeah, so sometime what you will get, it you will get the column as a string. So first of all, what we have to do is we have to apply the date into this. So we will override this column. How do you override this? This is the way, dot apply pd dot, pd is our pandas, we have shortened the name on the top, dot timestamp, not timestamp, date time. So it will be converting the number one is the convert column to date type. Okay, once it is converted, how will you check that it is now what you can do is you can check the what type of data is coming in this column. Just go column name, we have already given date dot date type. So if you will run this, it will show you now. Close the file, don't save. So line number 21, this is not the function. Okay, now you can see the date time. So what is the type coming? This line, this is the output of this line. We have date time format, so we can go ahead easily now, and I'll just minimize this window. We can add a new column. Now we have ensured that new DF. Now we will add a new column, age. So when you pass some name, new name in the bracket, following by the data frame name, the compiler will understand that it has to add a new column. So now what is the definition of new column? How will you get the new column? From this age, to get the age from the date column which we have in the data, we have to minus the time stamp. So PD means pandas dot timestamp. Okay, you will get timestamp and dot now dot normalize. Normalize. Okay. And then, yeah, I think we are done. And then we can write new df dot to CSV and we can check data, new data with age dot CSV. Now let's run this. We will see what is the output. New data with age. We will open this. So you see age is coming like these many days. Okay, this is coming in minus. And this days is coming because CSV, we are writing the data into CSV and CSV don't do auto formatting. If we will write same data into Excel, you will see the auto formatting. So what I will do now is, I will close this file first of all so that the program is not interrupting in between. Okay. So I will change this. I will write age to, I will keep this one, but write age to, I will come this side, do minus from this side. New df date. I will write Excel also. I have to change here to Excel and I have to change here new data. I will write like new Excel with and then dot xlsx. Okay, now run this code. So code is successfully done. Now let's see the file. Okay, new Excel with age. Let's look, have a look. So you can see it's a proper format, age format. You want to see the date? You can see the date 2014, these many days. Got it? This is the date. This is the age till today. Now let's see the CSV also. Where is the CSV? New data age with CSV. Here it is. Click on this file. You can see days. Two columns are added. So hope you understood the concept to add a new column. Okay. Now what is next? So I'll just leave you to practice further on this and then we will move on the next one. So now what is next? Next is the adding a new column with the string condition. So you understood with the date condition till now. Okay, I don't need this these rows anymore, so I'll just remove so that this becomes little good writing of code. You understood the concept already. Yes, so add new column with condition. Okay, so now let's see some column. Let's go over this column. So wherever month is less than 4, we will write Q1. Wherever month is greater than 4 and less than equals to 6, we will write Q2, which is quarter 2, and then Q3 and Q4 as per the same syntax. Okay, so there is a function called locate. I will be using locate. There are so many things which you can use. Df, so I'll be using the same new data frame, new df dot loc. What I want to locate is in the new df, okay, wherever I have to copy the name of the column. It is month number. I have to check for the space. It's not there. Month number is less than 4. So what I want to do, so this is my condition till here to here. Now my action will come after a comma. What I want to do is I want to add a new column which is quarter. Okay, it's like Q1. I want to write this way. Okay, so this is one. Now in the next line, I have to give two conditions. What are the conditions? So whenever this is less than, this is greater than 4, greater than and equals to 4, or I can say greater than equals to 4. And another condition, if I have to write two different conditions, I have to use this bracket, and then I have to copy this entire piece. I will just paste over here. Comma will come this side. Now two conditions you understood, and now I have to put the operator, which is and it is equals to 6. I'll say I think my condition is correct now. Yes, I have to write Q2. Okay, now next is, what is the next condition? I have copied the entire line. If it is greater than 6 and less than equals to 9, then I will write Q3, and the last condition will be explanation will be this one. You can just copy this code from here for fast writing. Paste it here. Whatever is greater than 9, everything has to be Q4. I don't think that I am wrong somewhere. Okay, so this is how you can write, and then let's write the updated data frame. Okay. This time that I would like to write into Excel. Quarter Excel. Dot XLSX. I don't want labels, so index false. Okay. So quarter Excel is here. Let me see. Quarter is updated successfully. So if you see January Q1, June Q2, December Q4, Q3 is July, August, September. Okay, so this is how you use the multiple conditions and locate function. You can practice it now. Alright, so now next is that condition with string. You have seen this condition with numeric. Now let me show you the condition with the string. And you have seen the AND operator, means both the condition has to be true. And I will show you OR operator as well. So what I will do is, I will copy the code from here itself. I will paste the code here. I have to see which column we can use. Alright, so if it is France or Germany, I will add a new column which is called continent. So what I want to do is, I want to check equals, and then this is the or sign, this is the single bar here. Okay, and then I want to, so what is the country, is the target column name where we are performing the filtration. Here what I want to check, it should be France. It has to be double equal or country is equals to Germany. This is coming with so this kind of, you know, signal will come because of you have to provide the so if this is the condition, I have to add a new column, continent. Okay, I don't, I'm not getting the spelling, so I will NTINENT, continent. All right, and I want to update here Europe. Do like this space. It will not give you any error, so space just to keep the code clean. So you see that we have this kind of things here also, but this is just a indicator that your code is not appropriate, but it will not give you error. Okay, so let's write the code and write the file once again. New df dot to Excel and then with continent dot xlsx and then you see run the file. With continent, you see the file here. You see, wherever Europe is there, either it will be France or Germany. France, Germany. Okay. Now, next question will be in your mind that what we will do with this blank, how do you fill the blank with your anything? I mean anything, when I say that any value you want to fill inside the blank. So, fill any, fill any. So, new df dot fill any whatever value you want to put. You can put here like non euro. So all the blank will be filled by this value, and then here you can inside you can put a comma and in place equals to true, means you are not assigning this to any other frame, but it should be with the same data frame. Then you write the file once again to Excel, updated with fillna.xlsx. Okay, all right, let's write the file. Updated with fill na, you can see the file, I think. Yes, now you see you go in the end. So wherever it is no Europe, it's Mexico or Canada. All right guys, so I am done with the today's exercise. I will tell you a few things that I have been using the data frame. I have been reading the data frame again and again. So you don't have to do it if you are working on single data file itself. But you have to always remember that whenever you are overriding the data, you have to be very careful. You should not lose anything on the old one. Okay. So what I will do is, you have already seen this much of code. This first 18 lines, okay, you can see, have a look once again. So all of these lines are comments which are gray color. This will not be considered as a code. These are just notes, you can say, in simple language. From 18th to end, you can have from here, okay, which I have told you in the second phase of this video. If you want to you have some query, you have some question related to anything else which you want to do in Excel, you can mention in the comment. And if you have some suggestions for me, I always welcome suggestions. You can mention in the comment. Please forward my videos and watch my videos as long as you can. It will help me a lot. Thank you very much for your time. Have a nice day ahead.